supper makes you fat, you should skip breakfast. These might be advice you've heard if you have been looking to manage your weight, in particular when people are referring to intermittent fasting. In this video, besides going into the science behind intermittent fasting, I will go through the fascinating evidence of why eating a late dinner or supper are a couple of the top things you could avoid if you are looking to maintain or reduce your weight. Hi, I'm Chung, a qualified nutritionist with a master's in nutritional sciences, here to share with you the latest evidence-based findings on healthy eating and living. It's January again, and you might have come up with a list of resolutions and things to accomplish for the year. And losing some weight, or maybe just maintaining your weight, might be something on your mind. In fact, drop the phrase weight loss into the comments if this is on your list of resolutions this year. I have previously done a video that discussed the details of how our weight is controlled by our energy balance. And the gist is, if you take in more energy through food and drinks compared to the energy you use throughout the day, you will gain weight. And the opposite is also true. Take in less energy than you expend and you will lose weight. Therefore, restricting our caloric input is essential to achieving weight loss, with the obvious advice to count your calories and just eat less. However, that is much easier said than done in real life, and to help you navigate this, I'll be doing a series of videos on a few weight management methods, as well as the science behind them that you could consider to help you in this perennial endeavor. So, what is the first weight management method that I would discuss today? It'll be the practice and related ideas to intermittent fasting. The most common version that many people are practicing is the 16-8 version, where you would eat during an 8-hour window and fast for the remaining 16 hours. Just a note that in the scientific literature, this way of eating is usually referred to as time-restricted eating. But I will use the term intermittent fasting in this video, since that is probably what most people are more familiar with. The 16-8 version of intermittent fasting is popular because of its ease of implementation without the need to count calories. Most people simply skip breakfast and start eating lunch around 12 p.m. and this will still allow them to maintain their social interactions eating dinner with friends or family before 8 p.m. So, what does the science say about intermittent fasting and weight loss? I'll go into that in a little bit, but before I show you the research, if you are enjoying this video, do hit the subscribe and the like buttons. That would really be the best way to support my efforts in making more videos like this, as well as help others find this video. You could also check out this other video where I go into other evidence-based methods for managing your weight. So, does the research show that intermittent fasting can help with weight loss? The short answer is yes, even though it is premised still on the fundamental idea of achieving a lower intake of calories. This interesting 2015 study first got participants to get used to taking a photo of everything they ate and drank over a 3-week period. Based on the initial 3-week data, the researchers saw that most of the participants were actually eating or drinking something for close to 15 hours of the day. The researchers then got 8 of these participants to shorten their eating duration by around 4.5 hours, such that they were eating for only 10 to 11 hours daily for 16 weeks. Over the 16-week period, the participants lost an average of 3.3 kilograms or 3.4% of their weight, with an estimated reduction in daily caloric intake of around 20%. This more recent 2020 randomized controlled trial with 58 participants randomized individuals into either a control group with no specified eating window, a 4-hour eating window group who ate from 3 to 7 p.m. and a 6-hour eating window group who ate from 1 to 7 p.m. After 10 weeks, while the control group essentially maintained their weight, both the 4-hour and 6-hour eating window groups lost around 3.2% of their weight, with an estimated reduction in daily caloric intake of around 30%. These studies, together with other similar ones, highlight one of the very appealing aspects of intermittent fasting, and that is, there is generally no need to count calories. By limiting the eating window to around 8 hours of the day, most people will naturally eat between 15% to 25% less calories, which is around 300 to 500 calories less per day. If maintained over a period of time, This would translate to a very sustainable weight loss of around 0.5 kg per week. Before I dive further into the mechanisms of how intermittent fasting works and also how to implement it in a healthy way, if you've learned something in this video, do help me by hitting the like and subscribe buttons. That would really be the best way to support this channel and encourage me to make more content like this. Also, if you have tried intermittent fasting, share in the comments how the experience was for you. Besides a caloric deficit, what are some of the other mechanisms behind how intermittent fasting helps with weight loss? To discuss these mechanisms, I'm going to go back to something I promised to talk about at the beginning of the video, and that is why you should avoid having a late dinner and especially stop eating supper. The first reason is that our body naturally has a fat-fast cycle, where within the first few hours after a meal, it is in a fat state where energy is generally being stored as glycogen and fats. And then after that, the body goes into a fasted state where it starts to break down these same energy stores to sustain our bodily functions. Nighttime when we sleep is actually a natural period of time when our body goes into a sustained period of a fasted state. And when we wake up in the morning, the body is generally in a state where it is breaking down fat stores for energy. This fascinating 2023 study placed 12 healthy males into a metabolic chamber for 2.5 days, where their energy expenditure, as well as the energy stores their bodies were using, were measured every hour. One of the key measurements showed that fat oxidation increased while participants were sleeping and actually reached a maximum every day right before breakfast. As such, what we also want to do is to maximize this natural daily cycle of fat burning. How can we do this? One useful guideline is to finish dinner 3 to 4 hours before bedtime. If you could finish dinner by 8 p.m. and you had breakfast the next morning at 8 a.m, that would have naturally given your body a 12-hour fasted window. With intermittent fasting, we are in fact just making full use of this and simply extending it by another 4 hours if you were to start eating at 12 noon. The second reason why late dinners or suppers cause weight gain is related to another fascinating area called chrononutrition, where the latest research has shown that our bodies could actually respond differently to the same food depending on the time that we eat. But the gist of it is that our body has a biological clock that is set by sunlight that influences the production timing of various hormones in our body. This includes melatonin, which is the hormone that signals to our body that it is time to sleep. This interesting 2017 study found that less lean participants ate more of their daily calories closer to when their bodies produced melatonin. In fact, participants who ate more of their calories within 4 hours of when their bodies naturally produced melatonin were found to have higher percentages of body fat. Therefore, putting everything together, the following are some of the concepts of intermittent fasting that you could implement to manage your weight more effectively. Number one, eat an early dinner, preferably finishing dinner 4 hours before bedtime. Number two, make sure not to eat or drink anything with calories after you end dinner. This would include any alcohol or beverages like Milo or protein drinks like Ensure. If you can achieve this, you have naturally given your body between 10 to 12 hours of fasting, even if you have breakfast the next morning. Number three, skip breakfast if you can achieve items number 1 and 2 comfortably. As with everything I discuss, it is not all or nothing. You can target a 16-8 routine, but even 14-10, which is fasting for 14 hours and then eating for 10 hours, would be better than nothing. Number four, in order to help you achieve items number 1 to 3, make sure to eat hearty, nutritious lunches and dinners that are filled with fiber and protein. Make sure that you are eating food that you enjoy as well. If you don't feel satiated or enjoy your lunch and dinner, you will simply be setting yourself up to feel unsatisfied, and before long, you will find yourself reaching for the late night snack after dinner. All that said, do I promote 16-8 intermittent fasting for everyone? No. If you are able to maintain a caloric balance, I highly recommend that you eat 3 meals a day to maximize the amount of nutrients that you expose yourself to. What I do recommend for everyone is that you should try to finish dinner about 4 hours before bedtime and give yourself a natural 12-hour fast as you sleep through the night before breakfast the next morning. In the meantime, if you would like more information on other evidence-based practices that could help you manage your weight, do check out these other videos. See you next time.